Okay, so welcome to part 3 of this video. I already recorded this, but for some reason it wouldn't import into Sony Vegas, so I'm going to do it again. Yeah, in the last video we were able to do damage to the enemy randomly, or I should say at random range. So now we have an arrow, and we can attack by pressing that button. Okay, so if you click upside it doesn't work, you have to click on the button. Now this is a good time, guys, to hit the like button and maybe subscribe if you're not subscribed. And if you're subscribed, you can always hit the notification bell next to the subscribe button. Okay. Yeah, let's have a look at the new changes. Okay, I made a new sprite. Yeah, so I just drew this. I drew this terrible looking arrow. Or like mouse pointer. You can probably make something better. I'll import the graphic from Le Photoshop. The new object is object 6. And I'm using the new sprite. Alright. If you double click on object 6, you can see that we have a new step event. Okay. So let me just... let me see. Let me delete this here. And I'm going to cut this and I'm going to bring it back to code because that's where it was originally. Let me see. I'm just going to put this back the way it was from the previous example. And this is pretty much what you have right now on your file. Okay. Now if you don't have this file, you can download it. It's under the description below. Alright, so this is pretty much what you have right now. So, let's just cut this here. And we're going to bring it to object 6. So go ahead and create this sprite. And create the object. So, this is object 6. And we are going to paste this here. Okay, and let me show you what happens. And this is what is going to happen. Okay, you are going to get an error message. Okay. These variables are inside code, so we have to type the name of the object dot player attack. Same for this variable here, it has to be code because it's not inside this object, it's inside code. So we just have to type code dot health. Okay, now these two has to be code. So basically every variable you have has to have code at the beginning because that's where they are located. So this should work the same way. Okay. No changes. We're still doing the same random damage. So let's make this arrow follow the mouse. Okay. Let's scroll up. Remember to insert a step event here. We're going to simply take a jump to point. Okay. And we wanted to follow the mouse. The mouse X. X position and the mouse Y position. So simple. So let's run this. And there you go. Now it follows the mouse pointer. Now this is only going to happen if the mouse pointer is overlapping our attack button. Let's do that. Let's find collision. Where is collision? Here we go. Drag this in here. And this is only going to happen if we are overlapping attack. Okay, let's drag this in here. So make this relative to itself and let's try it out. Let's click everywhere and it doesn't work. No, let's click the button. Whoa, and now it works with the button only. Okay, you can do the same thing for the rest of the buttons. In the next video, the enemy is going to attack our player. Alright guys, don't forget to smack the like button. See you in the next video. Bye now.